Hello, this is Roger with Google. This recording is a getting started using Google Drive on Microsoft Windows with the NVDA Screen Reader and the Firefox browser. In this recording, I will describe the major sections of the application, how to move between those sections, how to create, open, and manipulate files, and how to get additional information. Let's get started. I currently have my web browser open to google.com. So the first thing we want to do is go to drive.google.com. I'm going to do so now.
Navigation toolbar tool. Selection. Remove. Give. Unknown. Document. Working. My drive dash Google Drive dash Mozilla Firefox left parent private browsing right parent. My drive dash Google Drive document. Folder list viewed list. Stuff Google Drive folder owned by me last modified by me September 4th. Folders do not take up quota space not selected 1 to 5.
When you go to drive.google.com, the focus should be moved automatically to the file list, and you should be able to use the up and down arrow keys to read through the files. I do want to mention that NVDA should be in focus mode for the best experience when using Google Drive. But if it's not, you can use the NVDA plus the space bar to switch between focus and browse modes. So if you hear a tone like this, that means you are in browse mode. If you hear a tone like this, that means you're in focus mode, and focus mode is the mode that you want to have enabled. Google Drive has several major sections. The first one is the Google toolbar. Followed by that is the Drive search area. Followed by that is the Drive toolbar area. Followed by the Drive navigation area. Followed by the Drive file list area. And finally, at the end, is the Drive activity details area. You can move between these sections by pressing Tab, Shift Tab, or you can use keyboard shortcuts to move between these sections. Most of the sections, you navigate between them by using a two-letter combination of G followed by another letter, as in go to top, or you can use go to navigation, go to list, or go to details to move between those four major sections. You can go to the toolbar by using one of several keystrokes, for example, T to go to the settings menu, or C to go to the new menu. Once you're on the toolbar, you can use Tab and Shift Tab to move between the items. Finally, you can use the slash key to move to the search area. We will cover these keystrokes in more detail as we go through this getting started recording. To start with, let's make sure that our focus is on the file list. So I'll type in G, then L, as in go to list. Okay, nothing was verbalized, so that tells me my focus was already there. When you are on the file list, you can use the up and down arrow keys to explore the list of files. And I'm going to do a down arrow a few times now.
Success.mp3 audio owned by me last modified by me 12:24 p.m. File size is 21 kilobytes 2 of 5.
Again.
Example Google Docs owned by me last modified by me 12:23 p.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space 3 of 5. My travels shared Google Slides owned by Sundar Wisman last modified by Sundar Wisman August 18th. Google Slides files do not take up quota space 4 of 5.
As you can hear, there's lots of information being verbalized as I move through the file list. It'll give you the name of the file, the type, the date, and the owner of the file itself. The list of files can be displayed in two different ways. One is a linear list, which is the mode that I'm set in now, or you could have it set up in a grid list. To toggle between the two different views, press the letter V as in view to toggle back and forth. So I'm going to press V now to switch to the grid view.
Change to grid view. Folder grid view list. My travels Google Slides 4 of 5.
When in the grid view, you can use the left, right, up, and down arrow keys to move through the list of files. I'm going to press the right arrow now.
Success.mp3 audio 2 of 5.
And you will notice the amount of verbalization has been reduced. Now I'm going to go ahead and switch back to the list view by pressing the letter V as in view.
Changed to list view. Folder list viewed list. Success.mp3 audio owned by me last modified by me 12:24 p.m. File size is 21 kilobytes 2 of 5.
When you come to a file that you want to open up, you can do it a couple of different ways. You can press O to open the file, or you can press Enter. In this case, my focus is on a audio file called Success, and I'm going to go ahead and press Enter now.
Working. Section. Folder list viewed list.
Success.
Success.mp3 audio owned by me last modified by me.
I went ahead and hit the control key to silence the output. As you heard, it said success. Audio files and other types of files are often shown in a previewer, which is part of Drive itself. When that happens, you can also press the space bar to replay the file. I'm going to do so now.
Success.
Once you're done previewing the file, you can press Escape to return back to your file list.
Folder list, viewed list. Success, .mp3 audio owned by me, last modified by me, 12:24 p.m. File size is 21 kilobytes, 2 of 5.
I'm going to press down arrow.
Example, Google Docs owned by me, last modified by me, 12:23 p.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space, 3 of 5.
I'm also going to open this file by pressing Enter.
Document, example, - Google Docs.
So this opened up a Google document. Also note that in this case, it did open it up in a new tab. You can confirm this by pressing NVDA T as in tab title.
Example, - Google Docs, - Mozilla Firefox, left paren, private browsing, right paren.
In this recording, I'm not going to describe how to use Google Docs. You can find information on that by listening to the other recording for getting started using Google Docs. I'm going to close this tab and return back to my Drive tab by pressing Control W.
My Drive-Google Drive document. Folder list, viewed list. Example, Google Docs owned by me, last modified by me, 12:23 p.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space, 3 of 5.
Now let's create a new file. First, we want to go to the toolbar for creating files, which is called New. The easiest way to get to that is to press the letter C, as in create.
New menu button expanded, submenu, menu, submenu.
Now I'm going to press down arrow until I get to Google Docs.
New menu button expanded, submenu, folder 1 of 2, file upload 2 of 2, Google Docs 1 of 4.
I'm going to press enter to activate.
Document. You are online, untitled document-google-docs-mozilla-firefox-left-paren-private.
I went ahead and pressed Control to silence the output. Now I'm going to type some text into this file. I'm going to press on up arrows so you can hear what I typed.
Here is some text.
I'm going to go ahead and close this file by pressing Control W and return back to Google Drive.
My Drive-Google Drive document. New menu button collapsed, submenu.
At this point, our focus is still on the toolbar, and we want to go back to the file list by typing G, then L, as in go to list.
Folder list, viewed list. Example, Google Docs owned by me, last modified by me, 12:23 p.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space, 4 of 6.
Newly created Google documents have the name Untitled Document. Needless to say, that's not a very useful name, so let's go ahead and find that file by using the down arrow.
Untitled document, Google Docs owned by me, last modified by me, 12:57 p.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space, 2 of 6.
Let's rename this file. To do so, you bring up the action menu by pressing the letter A, as in action.
Preview 1 of 2.
Arrow down until you find rename.
Open with submenu 2 of 2. Share 1 of 5. Get link 2 of 5. Move 2. 3 of 5. Add star 4 of 5. Rename 5 of 5.
Press enter to activate.
Section. Folder list, viewed list. Untitled document, Google Docs owned by me, last modified by me, 12:57 p.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space, 2 of 6. Rename dialog. Please enter a new name for the item, : edit has autocomplete. Selected untitled document.
I'm going to type in sample. I'm going to press tab to get to the OK button.
OK button.
And press enter to do the rename.
Quote, untitled document, quote, rename to quote, sample, quote, dot undo.
I went ahead and pressed Control to silence the output. So now the file has been renamed to sample. We can also confirm by doing an up arrow and then a down arrow.
Stuff Google Drive folder owned. Sample Google Docs owned by me, last modified by me, 1:1 p.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space, 2 of 6.
This is a file that I really do want to keep around. So I'm going to open up the action menu again and then remove the file. I'm going to press A now.
Preview 1 of 2.
I happen to know that remove is the bottom menu item. Instead of using down arrow, I'm going to do an up arrow.
Remove 1 of 1.
Now I'm going to press enter to activate.
Folder list, viewed list. Success, .mp3 audio owned by me, last modified by me, 12:24 p.m. File size is 21 kilobytes, 2 of 6.
If you really didn't want to do that, you can do a Control Z as in zebra to undo. The file list can be changed to show different types of things. To change what's shown in the file list, go to the navigation area by typing G, then N, as in go to navigation.
Folders and views, tree view. Level 1, my drive collapsed, 1 of 5.
I'm going to do a down arrow to go through all the different items.
Incoming not selected, 2 of 5, level 1. Reset not selected 3 of 5 level 1. Start not selected 4 of 5 level 1. Trash not selected 5 of 5 level 1.
Now I'm going to do an up arrow to go back to incoming.
Start not selected 4 of 5 level 1. Reset not selected 3 of 5 level 1. Incoming not selected 2 of 5 level 1.
I'm going to press enter to activate.
Selected. Incoming viewed list. List. Wes Sunderwisman, September 23rd, Alice in Wonderland. Shared Google Docs download. Add to my drive. More actions. 1 of 2.
So now we have two files in the file list. I'm going to do a down arrow to get to the second one.
Wes Sunderwisman, August 18th, my travels. Shared Google Slides. Locating quote my drive quote. Download. More actions. 2 of 2.
Do an up arrow.
Wes Sunderwisman, September 23rd, Alice in Wonderland. Shared Google Docs download. Add to my drive. More actions. 1 of 2.
You may have noticed that the order of verbalization has changed to where now it tells you the name of the file owner before the name of the file. There's also some additional information in there that it said, like add to or locate in. If a file has been shared to you, by default, it's only available when you go to the incoming view. But if you want to see it all the time in your drive, you can add it to your drive. And when you do, then it'll say locate in. So in this case, the My Travels has already been added to my drive, whereas Alice in Wonderland has not. I'm going to do a down arrow again. This time, listen to it, and you'll note that it says locate in.
Wes Sunderwisman, August 18th, My Travels, shared Google Slides, locate in quote, my drive quote, download, more actions, 2 of 2.
I'm going to do an up arrow to Alice in Wonderland, and this time listen, and you'll notice it says add to.
Wes Sunderwisman, September 23rd, Alice in Wonderland, shared Google Docs, download, add to my drive, more actions, 1 of 2.
In this case, I do want this file to show up in my drive, so I'm going to press the letter A to open up the action menu.
Open with submenu 1 of 8.
I'm going to do a down arrow.
Share 2 of 8.
Again.
Get link 3 of 8.
Again.
Add to my drive 4 of 8.
Now I'm going to press enter to activate this menu item.
Alice in Wonderland has been added to my drive. Undo. Move to dialog. Child folders of my drive grouping.
As part of doing the add to, you also get the opportunity to move it into a subfolder. In this case, I don't want to, so I'm going to press escape to dismiss this move dialog.
Incoming viewed list. List. Wes Sunderwisman, September 23rd, Alice in Wonderland. Shared Google Docs. Locate and quote my drive quote. Download more actions. 1 of 2.
Now the verbalization for Alice in Wonderland has changed to where now it says locate in rather than add to. Now I'm going to go back to the navigation area and switch back to my drive. So I'm going to type in G, then N, as in go to navigation.
Folders and views, tree view. Incoming tube of 5 level 1.
Up arrow.
My drive collapsed, not selected 1 of 5 level 1.
Enter.
Selected. Folder list, viewed list. Stuff Google Drive folder owned by me, last modified by me, September 4th. Folders do not take up quota space, not selected 1 of 6.
Now I'm going to press the down arrow until we find Alice in Wonderland file.
Alice in Wonderland, shared Google Docs owned by Sunderwisman, last modified.
I went ahead and pressed Control to silence the output. If you want to check which view you're in, you can press NVDA plus T as in tab title. I'm going to do so now.
My drive dash Google drive dash Mozilla Firefox left parent private browsing right parent.
I'm actually going to go back to navigation and change my view to incoming.
Folders and views. Incoming not selected. Incoming viewed list. List. Wes Sunder.
I press Control key to silence the output. Now I'm going to do NVDA T again.
Incoming dash Google Drive dash Mozilla Firefox left parent private browsing right parent.
Now I'm going to go back to navigation and change back to my drive. I'm going to type G then N.
Folders and views tree view. My drive collapsed, not selected 1 of 5 level 1.
I did an up arrow to get to my drive. Now I'm going to press enter.
Selected. Folder list viewed list. Stuff Google Drive folder owned by me, last modified by me, September 4th. Folders do not take up quota space, not selected 1 of 6.
You can also look at file details or file activity. To do so, first find the file that you want to look at. I'm going to do a down arrow now.
Alice in Wonderland, shared Google Docs owned by Sunderwisman, last modified by Sunderwisman, 12:30 p.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space, 2 of 6.
Next, type in G, then D, as in go to details. To move focus to the details activity area.
Tab control. Details tab selected 1 of 2.
And there are two different tabs available, activity and details. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and leave it on details. To read through the details, switch NVDA back into browse mode by pressing NVDA spacebar. Then you can use the up and down arrow keys to read through the information.
Tab activity. Clickable link. Alice in Wonderland. General info region. Clickable general info. Type. Google Docs. Quota used. 0 bytes.
Now I'm going to go ahead and press NVDA space to go back into focus mode. And I'm going to type in G then L to return back to the file list.
Folder list viewed list. Alice in Wonderland shared Google Docs owned by Sundar Wisman. Last modified by Sundar Wisman 12:30 p.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space 2 of 6.
To locate files, you can use the up and down arrow keys to explore through your file list and enter the code into subfolders, or you can also use the search capability. I'm going to demonstrate that now. I'm going to press slash to go to the search field.
Search drive edit has autocomplete. Blank.
I'm going to type in the word people and then press enter.
People. Working. Search results list. List. People. Google Docs owned by me. Last modified by me. September 4th. Google Docs files do not take up quota space. Not selected. 1 of 2.
So we have 2 results. I'm going to press a down arrow so you can hear the second file.
How to get started with Drive PDF owned by me. Last modified by me. August 12th. File size is 3 megabytes. Quota used is 2 of 2.
I'm going to press the up arrow so you can hear the other file name.
People. Google Docs owned by me. Last modified by me. September 4th. Google Docs files do not take up quota space. 1 of 2.
I'm going to press NVDA plus T as in tab title.
Search results dash Google Drive dash Mozilla Firefox left parent private browsing right parent.
At this point, you can open or rename or manipulate the files as you choose. I'm not going to do anything right now, and I want to return back to my file list. To return to all your files, go to the navigation area and then press enter on my drive. So I'm going to type in G, then N now.
Folders and views, tree view. My drive collapsed, not selected 1 to 5, level 1.
I'm going to press enter to activate.
Selected. Folder list, viewed list. Stuff Google Drive folder owned by me, last modified.
I went ahead and pressed control to silence the output. Now my file list is showing all the files again, and I can confirm I'm back in my drive by pressing NVDA plus T.
My drive dash Google Drive dash Mozilla Firefox left parent private browsing right parent.
Google Drive has many shortcuts. One way to look at this list of shortcuts is to open up the shortcut dialog by pressing control forward slash.
Keyboard shortcuts dialog.
To read through the dialog, you will want to switch back to browse mode by pressing NVDA spacebar.
Keyboard shortcuts dialog. Keyboard shortcuts. Link view all shortcuts in help center bar button closed. Table with 32 rows and 2 columns. Row 1 column 1 column to heading level.
I press control to silence the output. Now I'm going to use T to move to the table.
Out of table. Table with 24 rows and 2 columns. Row 1 column 1 keyboard shortcuts dialog.
And I press down arrow a few times so you can hear the first few keyboard shortcut items.
Column to heading level 3 create. Row 2 column 1 shift plus F. Create column to folder. Row 3 column 1 shift plus T. Create column to document. Row 4 column 1 shift plus P. Create column to presentation.
At this point, I want to return back to drive. So I want to go back into focus mode by pressing NVDA spacebar. Press escape to dismiss the shortcut dialog.
Folder list viewed list. Stuff Google drop.
I press control to silence the output. Google has additional online documentation. You can find this a couple different ways. One is you can do a Google search for Get Started Google Drive with a screen reader. Or you can go to google.com/accessible. And there you will find information about this and other products, as well as links to our online documentation. Thank you for listening, and I hope you found this recording useful.
This work is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution 4.0 international license, which can be found at http://creativecommons.org/licenses/by/4.0/. You are free to share, copy, and redistribute this material in any medium or format.